And that's when a pen pal comes to visit me. Last week, my friend Miko from Japan came to my house on vacation. She got to stay with me for 3 whole days. And we had lots of fun. There was only one problem. Miko couldn't speak English very well. She's just starting to learn it back home in school. And of course, I couldn't speak any Japanese. So that first afternoon was pretty funny. Miko's father dropped her off at my house around lunchtime. "Hello, Miko," I said. "Ohio, Cricket," said Miko. "Would you like something to eat?" I said. Poor Miko looked like she couldn't tell what I was talking about at all. And I couldn't figure out what to say next. But then I had an idea. "Hungry," I said. "Are you hungry?" And I pointed to my mouth and pretended I was eating. Well, I must have looked pretty silly, but I think Miko understood. Because she did the same thing I did. And then she said, "Hi," and nodded her head. I figured "hi" must mean yes in Japanese. So I made Miko a peanut butter and bologna sandwich. That's my favorite lunch. Well, I guess I figured right, because she ate her sandwich even faster than I did. Then Miko got a big smile on her face and said, "Oishi." And then it was my turn to look like I didn't understand. "Oishi," I said. "What's that mean?" "Oishi," said Miko. And then she rubbed her tummy and smiled again. "Oh," I said, "you mean good. The sandwich was good." Miko nodded and said, "Hi, good." But then she said another word I didn't understand. "Arigato." "Arigato," I said. "What does that mean?" "Arigato," said Miko again. And then she put her hands together and made a little bow. "I know," I said. "I bet you mean thank you." "Hi," said Miko. "Thank you, Cricket." "You're welcome," I said, and then I put my hands together and made a little bow. Well, after that, Miko and I got along really great. And when she left, she gave me the most beautiful present. It was a pretty Japanese kimono, just like the one she wears at home. Maybe someday I'll get to visit Miko at her house in Japan. But I think I better learn a little more Japanese first, don't you think? In the country of Scotland, a little girl is called a bonny wee lass. I bet you already know a song from Scotland. It's called "My Bonnie Lies Over the Ocean." Let's sing it together. My bonnie lies over the ocean. My bonnie lies over the sea. My bonnie lies over the ocean. Oh, bring back my bonnie to me. Bring back, oh, bring back my bonnie to me. Bring back, oh, bring back my bonnie to me. Now we're gonna sing another song from Scotland and play a game too. It's called "Did You Ever See a Lassie?" Here's what you do. When I sing "skip this way and that way," you skip in a circle. When I sing "clap this way and that way," you clap your hands. When I sing "jump this way and that way," you jump up and down. Ready? Let's do it! Did you ever see a lassie, a lassie, a lassie? Did you ever see a lassie skip this way and that? Skip this way and that way, skip this way and that way. Did you ever see a lassie skip this way and that? Now get ready to clap your hands. Did you ever see a lassie, a lassie, a lassie? Did you ever see a lassie clap this way and that? Clap this way and that way, clap this way and that way. Did you ever see a lassie clap this way and that? Now you're going to jump up and down. Did you ever see a lassie, a lassie, a lassie? Did you ever see a lassie jump this way and that? Jump this way and that way, jump this way and that way. Did you ever see a lassie jump this way and that? My pen pal Cynthia from Australia knows how much I love stuffed animals. So every year on my birthday, she sends me one. They have such funny names, I have trouble remembering them. Maybe you can help me. I'll say, "Cynthia sent me a kangaroo. What did she send?" And you say, "a kangaroo." Each time, I'll name another animal. See how many you can remember. Here we go. Cynthia sent me a kangaroo. What did she send? Cynthia sent me a kangaroo and a koala. What did she send? Cynthia sent me a kangaroo, a koala, and a kookaburra. What did she send? Cynthia sent me a kangaroo, a koala, a kookaburra, and a kiwi. What did she send? Do they have some funny animals there or what? In a country called the Netherlands, there are lots of windmills and flowers called tulips. The little Dutch boys and girls who live there wear shoes made of wood. I know a song about some little Dutch girls, and I'd like to sing it for you now. Here's how you can help. Put five fingers up in the air, and when I say one went home, you'll put one of your fingers down. Ready? Here goes. Five little Dutch girls sitting by the door. One went home and then there were four. Cloppity-clop-clop clop down the street go the wooden shoes on the Dutch girl's feet. Did you put one of your fingers down? Now you should have four fingers up in the air. Four little Dutch girls I did see. One went home and then there were three. Cloppity-clop-clop clop down the street go the wooden shoes on the Dutch girl's feet. Three little Dutch girls I once knew. One went home and then there were two. Cloppity-clop-clop clop down the street go the wooden shoes on the Dutch girl's feet. Two little Dutch girls having lots of fun. One went home and then there was one. Cloppity-clop-clop clop down the street go the wooden shoes on the Dutch girl's feet. One little Dutch girl, now we're done. She went home and then there were none. Cloppity-clop-clop clop down the street go the wooden shoes on the Dutch girl's feet. Storybook adventures, they're the greatest kind. There's no end to all the fun you'll find. You can have adventures and still be safe at home with a storybook adventure of your own. Golly gee, we must have been around the world a couple of times by now. But there's one place we haven't been. And I'm going to tell you a story about it. Once upon a time, there was a cat named Puss in Boots who lived in my backyard. It was nice enough, but nothing much ever happened there. Puss in Boots was kind of bored. I want to see the world, he said. I want to see exciting things in faraway places. Well, said his sister Carla Kitten, I want to see exciting things too. But I think I'll start right here at home. Not me, said Puss. Why, I've heard that somewhere in the world there's a thing that runs and runs and never gets tired. And I'm going to look till I find it. So Puss in Boots got ready to go traveling. He packed his bag and polished his boots and bought a nice warm coat. His friends gave him a bon voyage party. That's a party you give when someone's going on a trip. Then Puss in Boots set out to find the thing that runs and runs and never gets tired. Carla Kitten stayed home. But every day she took a long walk and looked around at everything. Puss in Boots was gone for days. When he finally got back, his boots were worn down and his coat was covered with dust. Did you find it? Said his friends. Yes, said Puss. I found the thing that runs and runs and never gets tired. Can you guess what Puss in Boots found? Well, little Carly Kitten guessed it right away. You found a river, she said. A river runs and runs and never gets tired. We've got one right here at home, and I've seen it. You didn't have to go far away to find that. I guess you're right, said Puss. But while I was away, I heard about something even more wonderful. It's a thing that's invisible in the daytime, but plain to see at night. And I'm going to look till I find it. Then Puss in Boots left again, and this time he was gone for weeks. When he finally got back, he had holes in his boots, and his coat was all ragged. Did you find it? Said his friends. Yes, said Puss. I found the thing that is invisible in the daytime, but plain to see at night. Can you guess what Puss in Boots found? Well, little Carla Kitten guessed it right away. "You found a star," she said. "A star is invisible in the daytime, but plain to see at night. We've got them right here at home, and I've seen them. You didn't have to go far away to find that." "I guess you're right," said Puss. "But while I was away, I heard about something even more wonderful. It's a thing that follows you everywhere, and it does everything you do. And I'm going to look till I find it." Then Puss in Boots left again, and this time he was gone for months. When he finally got back, his boots were worn out and his coat was gone. "Did you find it?" said his friends. "Yes," said Puss. "I found the thing that follows you everywhere, and it does everything you do." Can you guess what Puss in Boots found this time? Well, little Carla Kitten guessed it right away. "You found a shadow," she said. "A shadow follows you everywhere and does everything you do. We've got them right here at home, and I've seen them. You didn't have to go far away to find that." Then Puss in Boots sat down and took off his worn-out boots. "You're right," he said to Carla Kitten. "I've traveled all over the world, and you've stayed right here at home. But you've seen just as many exciting things as me." "That's right," said Carla Kitten. "Traveling around the world is wonderful, and I'm going to do it myself someday. But just remember, there are plenty of exciting things to see right in your own backyard." Do you remember the Hawaiian word that means hello and goodbye? It's aloha. Well, I'm going to sing the aloha song again. But this time, it's going to mean goodbye. They say aloha, it means goodbye. They say aloha, must you fly? They say aloha, I'll miss you, friends. Won't you come and see me once again? You can turn my tape over now, or you can look in your activity book for more fun things to do around the world. But whatever you do, just remember,